Okay. Yeah, there we go. Oh, just let's back it up a bit. Okay. Hey guys, it's Snap here. We're finally coming back with another Smash video. Like, I feel like I should have really done more of these. Maybe not. Because, like, I only have, like, 2 or 3 on this channel so far. And also, since I'm too lazy to bring it over to my game room with the big TV and hook it all up because it's like a freaking mess over there, I've just decided just to re-plug it in at this TV. I'm back. And did you get a Switch, which will probably be never. The Smash Ultimate will definitely be the first game I buy. Because I'm like, you know, getting Smash Ultimate. With my friends, I'm like a freaking recovery master. Like, even when I'm like insanely high playing with my friends, I can still somehow like, be able to recover. So to do this, we're gonna go back into training mode. Well, into training mode. Okay, and more specifically, this is how to play with the Wii Classic controller. That one. It's very good. No. There are two different kinds, really three different kinds, but it's mainly just two. First one is... No, it's unholiness. Basically the new the actual good ones. And they are the good ones. That for example. But the good ones will use all of the stuff they need, all of the stuff they know how to play. We use their skills as ness, and we use them all well. Mainly a couple, mainly a few moves, like PK Thunder, and occasionally bring in a PK Fire, and rarely a PK Pulse, how you call it. But otherwise, yeah. So. It would take a lot of practice for his recovery. I've played as him a lot. And basically, if you're using a controller with a joystick, what you want to do is use it, go up, and then kind of like do a half circle. Like that. That's for attacking. And then, for recovering. Yeah. For recovering, it's more like go up. Then, to the left. Then down the left. And then... When it's under you, go up and then to the right, depending on which side of the screen you are. And then try to angle it. And when you're hitting yourself, if you're on the left side of the screen, try to hit yourself as close as you can to the left side of the desk. Which one, and then intent, whatever word I can use, then we'll make him go to the right. So for PK Pulse, you want to hold it down as long as possible, because the longer you hold it down, the more damage you can do. Jesus Christ, it's a fucking deadly move. Anyways. 37, just from one attack. And 74. You see, it's really open, but it's hard to. It's easier to learn than PK Thunder. But at the same time, and then, I'm pretty sure it's like, I don't even know what it's called. But, if you have like a, if you're at a really high percentage, and there's like, for example, like a fireball, a special move, or like a projectile special move that comes at you, if you do your down B, it'll go into this, and then it'll suck up the special attack, and then heal you. And also, it can protect you from explosions. Yeah. Okay, maybe I was wrong about the expression point. It just says one. Yeah, it doesn't know you from this person. So anyways, that was my somewhat in-depth guide of playing Ness. That was just a beginning. If you're going to use smash attacks, I really advise you to usually use the bat. Jesus Christ, you don't even want to know. Get over to the ledge. Yeah, the mid-air, these mid-air attacks. Jesus Christ. Yeah, that's also a bad situation for any of the people out there. Anyways, that was my somewhat in-depth guide to playing Ness. So yeah, please like and subscribe, and goodbye.